Greetings from Juvaluska, which is in Finland, where Angela and I are attending a missions festival. 10,000 people, 15 of them commissioned out to serve all over the world: Senegal, Oman, Nepal, Botswana, Israel. And they're going to spread the good news of Jesus Christ. This is the place where we have been sent from here to the nations, from Bay Area Community Church. And what a joy to bring greetings to Pastor Greg and Mary Kaye on the 25th anniversary of their servant leadership, faithful, diligent leadership at Bay Area Community Church.
And Greg always says that when Casely came to Bay Area Community Church, Ghana came with him. And when Angela came to Bay Area Community Church, Uganda came with her. So, Greg, you have taught us that everyone needs to be a missionary. Whether it is from where you came from or where you are, you need to be someone who is a missionary every day of your life.
Thank you very much. Thank you for teaching us a chapter a day for the rest of your life. You can always do more. And that is a message we share with the people that we come across, whether it is the Uber drivers that carry us from place to place, whether it is the people who wait on us at the hotels that we stay in, or the people that we brush shoulders with in the churches that we go to. Thank you for teaching us that we all need to be missionaries from here to the nations, wherever it is that God has placed us, in our homes, at our workplaces, in the churches, in the schools, in the hospitals, wherever it is that God has placed us. Your missionary passion for the nations is so contagious, and we are thankful to God for you.
And one of the best times we had was when we went on the edge with Greg. Casely and I went on the edge with him. We went to Uganda, to Ghana. They both went to India and traveled all over into 5 countries in 5 weeks. And we learned the passion of Greg, his love for people and for each and every one of us.
There we go. There we go. Now one is okay.
So this is to the next 25 years. May the Lord continue to bless you and keep you and give you an enduring, sustaining grace all throughout as you continue to bless the people of Bay Area in Annapolis and from Annapolis to the ends of the earth.
Pastor, on behalf of Josh, Drew, Kendall, and myself, we want to thank you for your great friendship, your support, and the fact you have always been there for us. Also, congratulations on 25 years in one place. If there was an election, it'd be unanimous. We love you. Congrats.
We want to thank you, Greg and Mary Kaye, for the impact you've had in our lives. And two particular defining moments I want to mention. The first one was about 23 years ago. We were sitting in Adam's Ribs with you, kind of at the beginning of our ministry. And you just really helped us to launch well and work through some things. And it was really a key time for us. The second one was about 7 years ago when our ministry in the Middle East came to a close. We had lots of questions and uncertainty and also heartbreak. And you really were faith-filled for us and really spurred us on. And those were really key moments for us, so thank you.
When I reflect back on you and your lives in ministry, two things stand out to me. One is your longevity in ministry, and that has meant perseverance, I'm sure heartbreak at times and disappointment, as well as a lot of victories and celebrations. And you've just been so faithful to live lives of integrity and in continuing to grow deeper in the Lord and really have your heart firmly in His. The other thing that has marked your ministry has been your commitment to family and ministry, and that has been something that has been such a model for us, your commitment to your children, to discipling them first, and seeing them in a healthy place, as well as your ministry. Mary Kaye, you've just been a phenomenal mother, mentor, and discipler, and your lives just shine for Jesus.
Greg and Mary Kaye, I love you, I love you, I love you. Anyway, I just am so grateful to just to be able to wish you well on this 25th, a wonderful occasion, and for your faithfulness to God and your faithfulness to one another is such a wonderful model. And just as thinking, we've had so many wonderful experiences together, and I'm so grateful. And I'm grateful most of all that he brought us together to walk this journey together, becoming more like Jesus together. That's a great gift from him. And I was grateful that we had the experience to go to California together and to experience the legacy of Dallas Willard. He was such a great model. And so your legacy, and it's gonna continue to be a great one. And I just like speaking a future to you. And I just am thankful that God's giving us more years to be on that with you. So just know I'm praying. Amen.
Well, dear friends, congratulations on making it these last 25 years. And we do praise God for your faithfulness. So many thoughts. Thankful for all the trips that we've had together, and the things that have been born out of our trips. That's most fantastic things. That I don't have time to go into it now, but I'm certain about this, that you all are, both of you are his workmanship. You are created in Christ Jesus unto good works, and you are growing, and you're going to be great oaks of righteousness, and the two of you together are going to be a really big oak. So I think of you, Greg, in the like a Bill Bright in the making, or Lauren Cunningham, or John Stott. And your combination is John Stott and Bill Bright, and being a teacher and also an evangelist and a missionary. And we are Missio Dios, and you're great examples, and the best is yet to be for you. Love you. We love you very much.
Amen.
Hey, Greg and Mary Kaye, just wanted to send a quick note to say how much I've appreciated your ministry over the years to our city and to our broader area, the Bay Area of Annapolis, and also to me and Katie personally. Greg, you have been such an encouragement and support as a mentor, and just given me timely input and prayer when needed as I'm facing things on the front line. Just your availability has been such a gift. And even more recently, walking the streets of Cuba. It was just an incredible time, whether it was there drinking from coconuts in Cuba or in India on the front lines a decade ago. Love you so much, love both of you so much, and I'm so personally so grateful for you and your ministry, your faithfulness over many years. Love you guys. Peace.
Hey, Greg and Mary Kaye, happy 25 years of ministry. My wife, Sarah, and I are very, very happy to be celebrating together with you this important time in your lives. And we just wanted to praise the Lord and let you know how thankful we are for your spiritual leadership, your guidance. You guys have helped us both navigate through quite some important times in our lives. As a result of that, we're even planting a church ourselves now, right? I had to take advantage of some promo here. But no, just in all seriousness, we're thankful for you. And we pray that God will continue to use you mightily, right?
Mm-hmm. When we think about the both of you, Greg and Mary Kaye, a verse comes to mind, and it's Hebrews 13:7, and it says, to remember your leaders, those who share the gospel with you, consider the outcome of their lives and imitate their faith. And we've considered and we've seen the outcome of your life. We continue to see the outcome of your life, and we desire to imitate your faith. We want to say thank you. We know ministry. We know firsthand ministry can get very busy, and you've always been there for us to listen to us, to guide us, to give us godly advice, and we thank you so much. Thank you, Mary Kaye, for all your invaluable parenting tips. We really appreciate both of you. We love you a lot. Happy 25th.
Happy 25.
Hey, Mom and Dad, congratulations on 25 years at Bay Area. I can't believe I was just shy of one when you all first came to Bay Area. And I just want to say thank you on behalf of all of your kids for the incredible impact that you have had, as you know, on each one of our lives. The fact that there are four of us still following hard after Jesus, so in love with him, it is a testament to you all, to your walks with him, to the way that you have prioritized your time with the Lord, the way you've showed us what it looks like to live a spirit-filled life, to follow after God in each and every step we take. Your ministry has gone into our lives, now into your amazing grandkids, all four of them that you have, which is just such a gift. So we rise up and we do call you blessed because you have paved a path, you have led the way for us. We love you so, so much. And congratulations on 25 years at Bay Area and on the ministry that you've had. It is a gift and a blessing to be a small part of it and a huge part of your lives and the legacy and ministry that you have.
Congratulations, Greg and Mary Kaye, on 25 years of faithful service at Bay Area Community Church. It's been a joy for Molly and I to be with you 22 of those years on staff and in gospel partnership and in friendship with you. We so appreciate you and how you've influenced us in so many ways. I could mention a number of areas that you've really influenced and God's used you to change our lives, but I just want to really just highlight one primary thing, and that is extravagant generosity. You have been a real picture and a model of God's heart of generosity to us. And I think back, and that's illustrated in two incidents that come to my mind. One was back in the early 2000s when we were getting ready to build the first building at Bay Area here at Chesterfield Road, and how you all sold off some of your land to take those proceeds and invest it in the stewardship campaign. Not only did you challenge us to give, but you modeled giving. And then more recently, just when you got some inheritance money from Mary Kay's parents, and how you took that money and you took it and cashed it out and invested in discipleship material that a chapter a day for the rest of your life, so that we would walk closer as disciples of Jesus. And I just want to thank you so much for the influence that you all have had on our lives through your extravagant generosity.
Well, first of all, Pastor Greg and Mary Kaye have been great friends ever since they've got here. I'm sitting in the Senate office, the office of the President of the Senate. This is where I sit when Greg comes. He sits right here, and invariably, when he leaves me a note and scripture. And I've saved every one of those notes. In fact, the last time he came, he even bought me a piece of shrub from the Garden of Gethsemane. He's just a very dear friend. I regard him sort of as a confessor, because he asked me how am I doing, and I tell him the issues that I'm dealing with, and he consoles myself as well as members of my family. These two people are just great people. They've built a great church, and they have a great following outside the church, including myself, my wife, my children.
Hello, I'm Pamela Palumbo, CEO of the Pregnancy Clinic Ministry. Decades ago, as I got to know Pastor Greg and Bay Area, I was struck by how tightly they hold the things of Christ, but how loosely they hold the things of the world. This was evident when, as 884 launched, they made sure they let us know that they were all in on supporting the clinic as well as other ministries around the world, because 884 wasn't just about a building, it was about the gospel. And I've been deeply moved as when we first rented the Annapolis Pregnancy Clinic on West Street, that Bay Area sent out Pastor Greg and Mary Kay's missional community to come for a tour and prayer. They came just as a regular couple in their missional community, and yet as they left, Pastor Greg turned to me and said, Pamela, I feel like that God is calling us to partner with you to make this a permanent home for ministry here. That was a surprise because our board hadn't even considered that yet. And yet, as we watched that partnership deepen and the elders came out and our board prayed, things became evident. And from that, hundreds of preborn babies' lives have been saved, and thousands of the unreached women and men on West Street have heard the gospel. Pastor Greg and Mary Kaye, congratulations on 25 years of ministry. I can't wait to see how God uses you in the next 25.
What's up, Greg? What's up, Mary Kaye? Hey, I'm coming at you guys live from this location. Live for me, recorded for you. Because this is a spot, I don't even know how long ago it was, maybe 10 years ago, that after Josh lost his diver's watch fishing here with his sons, I think that's what happened, me, Josh, and Greg, and a guy named Mark Andres came back here in swim trunks in this nasty water and went diving. And can I tell you that diving in the South River with no goggles or anything, trying to find a watch in the mud under here, under this bridge, is about impossible. But Greg manned up and he got in and he went scuba on this thing. And when we got out, I thought a couple things. One, Greg's in pretty good shape, actually, you know, for being the upwards of 5'0". Maybe 6'0 now, bro. I'm not exactly sure. But he's in good shape, and man, what an awesome thing to get in here with a bunch of young guys and try to do the impossible. And I really appreciated that, Greg. One other quick story that came to mind was when you and I were doing a prayer walk around the parking lot of Bay Area. And it's when I wanted to be a teaching pastor, and you said, I don't even know if you remember this, but you said, Pat, if you're gonna have teaching pastor below your name on your office door, you need to go take Greek. And I thought, man, that is the last thing that I wanted to hear. But you were so right. And it encouraged me to dig deep into the word and to apply myself. And time again, you did that in my life. And so from Kristen and I to you and Mary Kaye, and Mary Kaye, let me just say, shout out number one, you light up a room. Everybody knows that who is around you. And number two, being a pastor's wife for a guy who's trying to lead like a global movement of everyone a missionary is probably one of the hardest jobs on the planet, because you have to be so above and beyond in your giving to give Greg away so much, and then to manage everything else that comes alongside of that. So MK, huge shout out to you. All that to say is, I'm not jumping in here because it's nasty, but I wanted to come here just to say, Greg, we love you. We're thankful for your ministry and faithfulness to Jesus, because when we're around you, you actually help us to get closer to him.
Dzień dobry, Greg i Mary Kaye. Dziękujemy Panu Bogu za was. Mieliście i ciągle macie duży wpływ na nasze życie, dla naszej misji, dla wypełnienia naszego powołania. Bardzo zawsze nas zachęcaliście i pamiętam, nawet zapłaciliście za naszą przeprowadzkę do Rosji, jak jechaliśmy z małymi dziećmi. Zawsze czuliśmy zachętę i wsparcie od was. Kiedy wróciliśmy z misji w Rosji, założyliśmy szkołę misyjną, Greg powiedział, ta szkoła jest kolejnym krokiem w wypełnieniu marzenia, aby stała się Polska krajem posyłającym. Od dawna to jest nasza misja, że Bóg użyje Polaków po to, aby dotrzeć zwłaszcza do narodów byłego Związku Radzieckiego i Europy Wschodniej.
Dziękujemy wam też za waszą wizytę w zeszłym roku u nas, za to, że zachęcaliście nas i zadaliście dużo dobrych pytań. Dziękujemy wam bardzo za to, że możemy liczyć na was, na wasze modlitwy i wsparcie.
Dziękujemy.
Hi, BACC. Welcome to India. Namaste. Namaste. Pastor Greg is a great visionary and a missionary. He has a heart to serve the whole of the world.
praying, loving, and caring are His attributes. Mary Kaye is a gracious mother.
Mary Kaye has an open heart to serve the Lord and the people. Pastor Greg, in his first visit to India, he has given me guidance on administrative structure, and that has developed ICBM into 7 states of southern India. Pastor Greg, second time when he has come, he has ordained all our pastors. Then he has enhanced the support from $10 to $50. And a story goes, Pastor Greg was going around this headquarters. He has given encouragement to go for first floor, second floor, and third floor. And God has made it. And also Pastor Greg has raised his hand and prayed for the land surrounding this building to have a Bible college. You know, after many years, God has made it success. We praise the Lord, and we praise Pastor Greg and Mary Kaye.
Hi, Bay Area. This is Sergey Chervenko from the Moscow Evangelical Christian Seminary, and I'm happy to say a couple words about Pastor Greg and Mary Kaye ministry. Hi, Greg. Hi, Mary Kaye. I know you look at this and watching this video. My first time in Annapolis, when I spent about 20 hours on a flight, Greg met me in midtown Annapolis and said, "Hey, Sergey, you need to adapt to this time zone, so you need to stay awake." And he took me on his prayer pew on the city hall, and he prayed about Annapolis. We prayed about Annapolis, about Maryland, about country, and it's touched my heart. I saw what Pastor Greg has a heart about the Bay Area, about this region, about his nation. Pastor and Mary Kaye, they have not only dreaming, they not only dream about mission, they have vision what they can share, and people capture this vision and they want to be a part of this vision and participate in this. And the Moscow Seminary, of course, the part of it, but it's very important thing when someone has a vision like this. Thank you, Pastor Greg. Thank you, Mary Kaye. But you are part of his ministry, because it's for me just impossible to separate you. You both doing this ministry, and we love you. We are very grateful and thankful for your ministry. And I can say спасибо in Russian. That means thank you. And я люблю вас. Я люблю вас. It means we love you. Thank you very much. And God blessings to you all. See you soon. And thank you, Bay Area. Hey.
Hello, Bay Area Community Church. This is Pastor Stephen Matiang. Hello, Bay Area Community Church. This is Pastor Stephen Matiang from MGC in South Sudan. Hello, Bay Area Community Church. Hello, Bay Area Community Church. This is Pastor Stephen from MGC in South Sudan. Thank you for giving me this opportunity to share a few words with you concerning Pastor Greg and his wonderful wife. I first met Pastor Greg in year 2005 in South Sudan. Without such a historical visit, this good relationship between Bay Area Community Church and MGC would not have been possible. But with passing of time, I came to learn that Pastor Greg is a humble man of God who love to live and to do God's will, to love and serve Him and His people, not only in USA, but in Russia, Poland, India, Lebanon, South Sudan, Uganda, and Ghana, among others. Great and blessed is a nation that is served by such a wonderful man of God. Blessed and great are the people who are led by such a godly man. Great and blessed is a church that is served by such a wonderful man with his wonderful wife. May God bless Pastor Greg and his wife Mary Kaye and their children. May God give them more years to serve Him. May God bless Bay Area Community Church in USA. May God bless you all.
Hi, Greg and Mary Kaye.
Cześć. Greetings from Poland.
We're really excited that we could be just a little bit part of this. Greg and Mary Kaye, we just wanted to tell you guys how much we appreciate you. You complement each other as a team, as a married couple, in life and in ministry. Greg, I so appreciate you over the years, how much you're in tune with Jesus, how much you're spiritually sensitive, and of course you're visionary, and I love being around visionaries, and you're one of the top three people to talk with about vision, about church planting, about discipleship, and I just so love our times together. So over the years, you have put so much into my life, being able to just being my sounding board and being able to talk with you and dream with you and talk about future hopes for Poland and for the mission. So I just really appreciate all the times I could have spent with you. And you're a good friend, not just a ministry partner, but you've been a very good friend and one that I could share my personal struggle with, and one that I could just share my hopes with. So I really appreciate you.
And I'm so happy you married to Mary Kaye. I cannot imagine you without her. I think she's one of my best friends and I really miss her. And Mary Kaye, I just want to tell you that you're one of the best examples of wife and pastor's wife for me personally. And you've been a great, just a great friend. And you've heard my heart, so you've listened to me, and you always are just so wise and encouraging me. And so I'm just wish I could be there and to tell you that, and to hug you, to tell you how much I love you and how much I appreciate your ministry to me and to Poland. Both of you guys, you know, you've been a huge part in your church and our ministry here in Poland. And we are very, very, very thankful.